Hello friends, it's Claude and I'm back with another video. So today I am going to be giving you my review on the Seven Realms series by Cinda Williams Chima. Now, I didn't read this in like one straight sitting. I read this in the span of 2 to 3 years. I read the first book in 2019 and then I reread it last year because I couldn't really remember much of what was happening. And then yeah, I also read the second book last year and then the third and fourth book this year. So the first book is The Demon King, the second book The Exiled Queen, the third book The Grey Wolf Throne, and the fourth book The Crimson Crown. Now this is the kind of series that mostly progressively got better. The only book I didn't like was the second book, The Exiled Queen. I didn't like it because it was just so slow. And after reading it, I do realize that all the info dumps and the slow pacing, I think, was probably just to prepare for the coming books, which is fine. It was worth it in the end, but it was really slow. Like, I was trudging through. There was so much information. The magic system wasn't like registering in my head, but yeah, overall I love the series. This is now one of my favorite fantasy series. I think this is YA. Yeah, this is YA. It's not middle grade, it's YA. And here's the thing about it, okay? While reading it, I kind of tend to forget that the main characters are in their late teens. I keep forgetting that. I swear there's just something about the writing that makes me think the characters, the main characters, are in their early to mid-teens, which by the things they do in the book is definitely not the case. They are definitely in their late teens if they are. Yeah, they're teens. But yeah, there's just, I don't know, because when I read The Demon King, the characters just felt so young. And then as it went on, because I think the whole story takes place in less than 2 years, more or less. These characters just feel so young in The Demon King, the first book, that when I read the second, third, and fourth, and then they do like some not so PG-13 things, I'm like, wait a second, how old are you again? Also, the romance, you know, I expected this book to have romance, but I will be honest, I was not expecting these two specific characters to be the main couple, which at first I was like, meh, it's fine, it makes good story. But over time, I think it was by the later in the third book, when I was starting to root for them, I was like, oh my god, you guys have to be endgame. And then when I was reading the fourth book, I was so scared that we were gonna have a Romeo and Juliet situation. Thankfully, did not reach to that point. And I will say that this book does have a happy ending. That's very vague, okay? It does have a happy ending, which is why I rated the last book 5 out of 5 stars, because if it did not have a happy ending, I would have been so mad. For the series in its entirety, my overall rating for it is 4 out of 5 stars, just because I didn't like book 2. Really, like, but what book 2 did give was more of a world building. And I will say that the main characters, because this book is dual POV, so we get it in turns, there's like low-key a bit of the miscommunication trope. Okay, because I'm not a big fan of the miscommunication trope. Like, honestly, the miscommunication trope annoys the living shit out of me. But in this book, the miscommunication trope works. It works not only because you actually see both sides of the story, but because it does get resolved quickly enough. Long enough for there to be some conflict and drama, but not so long that it's just a repeating thing over and over and over again. So yeah, I'm okay with the miscommunication trope in this book. And then also, the characters, the main characters, they're character development throughout the books was really good. Especially Han. His character development. Oh my god. His character development is now one of my favorites throughout, like, all the books I read in YA. He's one of my favorites. I just like how it went from where he started to where he ended up. Basically, the gang version of Rags to Riches. Also, this book. If you like things that are like Game of Thrones, this is like baby Game of Thrones. There's a lot of political intrigue and betrayal. So if you feel like jamming out to Olivia Rodrigo, this is a pretty fun book to read. You're still a traitor. In both, like, the whole romance, the betrayal, the political intrigue. Just put Olivia Rodrigo, put her album on a loop, okay? Just, it's fun. I will also say that because book two was just so hard to read, it was a little hard for me to understand the magic system, because book two is heavy with information about the magic system and the whole world building, but none of it was sinking in. But it is easy enough to understand just by reading the plot and understanding what's happening. So it ain't that big of a deal. Yeah, I really like this series. I definitely plan on reading Cindy Williams Chima's other books. If you guys have read any of her other books before, you know, please leave a suggestion down in the comments. If you have any thoughts about this series, if you've read them before, please let's talk about it in the comment section. Or you can DM me on Instagram. But yeah, that's it for my review. Overall, I liked it. It was fun. It was a good read. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe. Click on the bell icon. Leave a comment down below. And yeah, that's it, you guys. I'll see you in the next one. Bye!